Hi folks, hope you're okay today. We're here to share with you the Word of God. We're here to share the Word of God in Matthew chapter 28. We read these words. It says, go therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. It says, baptizing them. Go therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name. It says, go therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. The name of God was precious. The name of God was precious. Jehovah, Yahweh, God is the true God. And the name of God showed the character of God. So when Jesus says, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, he's baptizing in the name of God. That he's saying that he is God. When Jesus was on a mountain, he was worshipped. When Jesus rose from the dead, Thomas bowed before Jesus. Thomas bowed before Jesus and said, my Lord and my God. The meaning to life, the meaning to purpose to life, is to know that behind this world, behind this universe, was created by God. That we can have a relationship with God and fellowship with God and know God as our Father. But the only way to know God as our Father knowing God in the Spirit. You know, pure love, pure joy, pure peace, that's God. But when you come to know God, you find that pure joy, pure peace in your life. When I was your age, I used to go into all the ways to get the God, I used to go to violence. There's no peace. But when you come to know God, he brings peace, he brings all. Here's a question for you, which is more logical? To believe that there's no mind in God, or a mind. If I throw paper on the floor, bits of paper, just screw it up, throw paper, what chances of all that paper writing? I love it.
That's
we're saying that the universe happened by no chance, no means, no purpose. So that's why we're here today. We're here to share with you God punishing you. Jesus Christ died in your place. Died on that cross. Once you acknowledge that, yeah, he died for you. He was punished for you. You think you've got to repent. You've got to turn away from the things. Like all this year, think of the bad things you've done. All the bad things you've done. Are you going to continue to do them? Or are you going to ask God to say, forgive me? You died for me, Jesus.
Christ the Lord!
Are you going to ask for forgiveness? So we're here to tell you about God, that you can have a relationship with him, that you can know him, that you can be with him, that you can walk with God, that you can talk with God. But how do you get to have a relationship with him? How do you get to have a relationship with God? by knowing that he paid your debt, by knowing that the Son of God paid your debt. You see, we all have a debt to God. It says in the Word of God, all fall short of the glory of God. We are all rebels. We don't like to be told what to do. We don't like to be told what to do. But the Word of God tells us what to do, not to lie, not to steal, not to commit adultery. Honor your father and mother. Honor the Sabbath day. Don't swear. Don't use the name of God in vain. The Word of God tells us these things. Not to do them. Not to use his name in vain. Not to swear. And we do them. We rebel against God. And then we have guilt. But Jesus Christ came and dealt with our guilt. He died on that cross and shed his blood and dealt with our guilt. He dealt with our guilt by dying on that cross, by shedding his blood on that cross. When he died on that cross, he shed his blood on that cross for you and me. Think of it, the Son of God who knew no sin, the Son of God who never lied, the Son of God who did no wrong, came down and died on a cross. And when he died on that cross, he suffered and took your punishment. He took your judgment upon himself. And he lay on that cross with a crown of thorns upon his head, nailed to that cross, shedding his blood on that cross. And he shed his blood for your wrongdoing and my wrongdoing. And if you turn away from the old life, if you turn away from that which is wrong and turn to Christ and turn to the Lord and trust him as your Lord and Savior, then you become forgiven. You become cleansed, you become renewed, you become a new man, you become a new woman, you become what is the Bible calls born again, you become saved. You become saved. You come out of darkness and into light. You come out of the darkness into the light. You come into the joy of the Lord, you come into the peace of God, you come into the light and you leave the darkness because he died on that cross. And he died on that cross to set you free today. It says, call upon the name of the Lord and thou shalt be saved. You've got to call upon him and cry out to him and say, Lord, have mercy upon me. And you might say, Jay, well, what about suffering in the world? Why is there all the suffering in the world? Why are all these problems in the world? Why are the wars? Why are there all these evil things going on in the world? Why doesn't God stop it right now? Why doesn't God stop it right now? If he stopped it right now, would you go to hell? Are you ready to meet him? He's given us time to repent. He's given us time to change. He's given us time so that we might find him and seek him while we can. He's given us time so that we can seek him right now. This is not man's world. This is not man's throne. Man might have thrown out God, but God ain't off his throne. God's still on his throne. You said, Jay, I don't want to know God. I don't think there is a God. I don't care about there's a God. But it don't change the fact that there is a God and he's on his throne. He is a sovereign God. And he's on his throne, and on his throne, he came down and died on a cross. And he died on that cross to set you free. He died on that cross and paid your price. That is the only way to heaven. The only name upon which we can get to heaven, the only name that you can get to heaven is the name of Jesus Christ. Christ Jesus, the anointed Messiah. The Lord of glory, Kyrios, says the Greek. The Lord, Jesus Christ. He is the Lord of glory. He is the Lord of history. He is the Lord of philosophy, of science. He is the Lord of morality. He's called Lord Jesus Christ, Kyrios, Lord. And every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And every knee will bow to him and praise him and worship him and adore him as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He is the Lord of glory. And the Lord of glory came down and became a man. And when he was born, the wise men came and they gave praises, they gave mirth, and they bowed and they worshipped him. They worshipped him. They worshipped the Son of God. They worshipped the Christ of glory. They worshipped him and they praised him and they adored him. Do you praise Jesus? Do you praise him as your Lord? Do you praise him as your King? Do you praise him as your God? The Lord Jesus Christ? Do you praise him? Do you honor him? Do you love him? Do you bring glory to him? Do you want his glory in your life? Do you want to lift him up? Do you want to praise him and adore him and worship him and say, you are my God, you are my King, I praise you, I worship you, I give you the glory, I give you the honor in my life, Lord? Or are you going to be the King of your life? Are you the King of your life? Are you on the throne? Are you the King? Well, you're not the King. No matter how much you think you're the King, you're not the King. There is one greater than you, and his name is Jesus Christ. And one day you and I will have to bow before him and answer to him, and he is the King. They love their pleasures. They may love their money. They may love their sex. They may love their religion. They may love it. They may love their glory. They may love their money. They may love their sex. They may love their drink. But it don't change the fact that there is a God. Holy, 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 there is a God. There is a God to live for, a God to glorify, a God to adore. There is a God. And this God did not leave you. This God came down in Jesus Christ. This God came down in Jesus Christ. And they arrested him, and they laughed at him, and they mocked him, and they whipped him, and they humiliated him, and they spat at him. Son and the Holy Ghost. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Baptizing them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Go ye therefore and teach. Baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Go ye therefore, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. He has the same name as the Father. He has the same name as the Father. Baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Jesus Christ is God, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. He is God to be worshipped, God to be adored, God to be praised, baptizing in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. He is the one with authority, Christ. Christ the Lord. Christ the Lord. Christ the Lord. And when you meet Him, when you find Him, when you trust Him, you find a Lord that will forgive you. You find a Lord that will be merciful to you. You'll find a Lord that you can be forgiven. A God that will forgive you. A God that will cleanse you. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. It says, I am with you always. I am with you always. He says, I am with you always. He says, I am with you always. And if you trust Him, He will always be with you. If you trust Him as your Savior, you will always know a Savior that will be with you, that will never leave you, that will never forsake you. I will be with you always, He says. Always. And if you come to know God, if you come to know Jesus, He will be with you always. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He'll never abandon you. He says, I will be with you always. Always to the end of the world, to the end of the age. Which shows you that He is God. Jesus was not just a man, but He was God. He was the Son of God who created this world. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And He says this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Name was the beginning with God, all things were made by Him. Without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of man. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. The world is in darkness. The world is in darkness. The world is lost. The world cannot see. The world doesn't know where it's going. The world doesn't know what it's doing. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. He made all things. Christ made all things. He is the light of the world. He is the light that shines in this world, and the world is in darkness, and the world cannot see its darkness. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. And there is a light of the world, there is a light, and that light is Jesus Christ. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that comes into the world. And He lights every man. Lights you, sir. He gives light and life. He is the light of the world. He is Christ who gives light to the world. He is the Savior who created the world. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that comes into the world. The true light. The true light is Jesus Christ. The true light is the Savior. The true light is the Lord. The true light that you need in your life is the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the true light. He is the light that needs to shine in your life. He says, I am the true light. He is the true light. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. It shows you how dark we are. It shows you the darkness of our hearts. It shows you how dark we are when God created the world and he comes to the world and we don't know who he is. It's because our hearts are dark. Our hearts are dark. We love darkness rather than the light. But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become sons of God, even to them that believe in faith. Power to believe in God. Power to believe in Jesus. Power to be born again. Power in him. Power in Christ. Power in the Lord. To be born again. To be born again, he says. But as many as receive him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. He gives power to become sons of God. To be a son of God. To be a son of God. To be a son of God by the power of God. To be a son and daughter of God. To be a son of God. To know the power of God in your life. The son, to be a son of God, to allow God to come in, to be a son of God, to allow God to come in by the power of the Holy Spirit, to be a son of God, a son of God, where God comes in and God changes you, to be a son of God, allowing God in your life, allowing God to change you, allowing God to make you. To be a son of God. don't know what that's in the word.
Thank you.
Jesus commanded to do that.